ब्रह्मानं विदधाति पूर्वम् यो वै वेदादुश्च प्रशृणोति तस्मै संहदेवम् आत्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये. Adore and surrender to the lotus feet of the Supreme Force who generated the primogenitor of the cosmos and who instilled the seed of root of wisdom, the primeval element of wisdom inside him, and who is responsible for the stimulation of the auto-intellectual instinct to the aspirant of emancipation. I surrender to him. Taking into consideration the topic today, the inaugural address, not only as a methodology by which, as a Swamiji, we have to render our blessings for a successful venture with the institutions we have commenced, summarizing the various levels of perception in both the sides of knowledge or both the parts of knowledge, or hemispheres of knowledge. First, let us commence with the definition of science, and then with spiritualism, and the interrelativity of spiritualism with religion and philosophy. Then, coming into history of cosmology, as perceived by different schools of thought, and also, specially focusing on gravity and history of gravitational theory, as well as the observation of the same gravity by the astronomers and the Vedic seers, as well as adumbrating the glimpse of the unexplorable and explored regions of the gravitational force and gravity to both the ends, and the purpose of research or study of gravity, as well as the purpose of conducting such seminars. This is the methodology, or this is the way by which we want to summarize the concept as the inaugural address. So, jignyasa, jnatum ichha jignyasa, knowing about his own physical stature, which has the end in knowing about the cosmophysical body, the macrocosmical body, the rat, the rupa, Brahman, the ultimate reality. So, depending upon his caliber and his capability and accessibility, the taste of a person's pursuit towards wisdom is defined and designed. Science, basically, any informative or any compendium of authoritative and empirical information that is meant for the welfare of the mankind in long run, that reveals the mysteries, puzzles, riddles, and the explorabilities of the surrounding, that is known as science. Science is an art. Science is an attempt. Science is a finance. Science is an austerity. Science is a compilation of observations, experiments, excavations, and implementations of various theoretical and technological backgrounds bearing by the person gets relieved from nescience and insufficiency of the evil impacts of nescience, oblivion, false apprehension, misapprehension, etc. So that is known as science. Science is the indubitable compendium of sources of knowledge on any faculty, on any field. So it is vast, it is endless. So says the Vedas, Anantavai Veda, it is endless. Even though the categorization of the Vedas are found to be four, Anantavai Veda, there are infinite and immeasurable resources of knowledge. So the Vedas are also infinite and immeasurable. The pursuit of Vedas, here it has been well explained that one deals with the creator and other deals with the creation. But we have to understand, as per the statement of Max Planck, he will say, for religion, God is at the beginning, or for science, he is at the end. That is the statement of Max Planck. So, knowing about the fundamental factor and explaining and experiencing the derivative factors is spiritualism. Knowing about the fundamental factor, experiencing and get explained and elucidated about the derivatives is spiritualism. Knowing about the derivative factors and trying to know and perceive about the fundamental factor is science. So here, knowing the fundamental unit, yena vijnana yena sarva vijnanam bhavati, by knowing the preliminary navel factor by which all these things have managed and emancipated. A clear vision, the vision with purity, clarity, the expression with articulate and ascertained background is there in the spiritual philosophy. The problem may be the scarcity of availability of such philosophers who are ambiversatile or multiversatile, and moreover the tradition being very esoteric rather than exotic. So the differences of science and philosophy or spiritualism, we have to now classify. First, spiritualism is a study of the imperceptible force. The concept of spiritualism or spirituality has been lexicographically derived from a chemical attribute known as spirit. So the unseen driving force that acts and activates upon the various observations in a laboratory, which was named as spirit, has been attributed to the unseen driving force in all mechanisms. So that is why the mechanism of soul or ontology has been attributed with the spirit, and then as a relative coinage of words, spiritualism, spirituality, spiritualism, etc. So the spiritualism is the study of the fundamental spirit. Then in the second stage comes philosophy, third is a religion. They are not different from each other, but their coverage is vast. If you see spirituality, understanding or an attempt to understand the primitive force, primordial force, then it encompasses the whole globe. If it is taken into account, philosophy, what is philosophy? It is very simple, derived from the same etymological root of philosophia, which means love or craving for knowledge. That is philo-anthropy, which means love towards fellow human beings. So craving towards knowledge is philosophy. So as the presidential address clearly evinces that philosophy encompasses anything, it may be in social sciences, humanitarian sciences, life sciences, everything it encompasses, even cookery, it has its own philosophy, those who love cooking. So love towards knowledge is philosophy. But still, even though gender peace is considered to be wealth or richness, part of richness, a person owing that negligible money or owning that money cannot be considered as rich, because it requires a considerable amount for fixing that nomenclature. A person who is possessing a negligible amount of a phenomena, even though there may be possession, there must be a considerable and also an acquired possession to be befitting to the nomenclature. Just as richness is that even in meager wealth, people are joyful to be aristocratic, plutocratic and rich only if they gain a considerable status of wealth position. Likewise, love towards knowledge is very much observable in the form of craving towards various portions of science by various types of people as well as the productivity of their intellectual inclination. But still, that which is on the basis of the foundation thought for understanding the fundamentals of universe, that deserves to be called as philosophy. Even though philosophy, as per academic pursuit, lexicographic understanding and etymological derivation, it can denote any faculty in which there is an attempt towards an innovative approach for gaining knowledge, that which tends to reach a person at a such level where the person gets consummate wisdom, perplenary wisdom, which gives him perennial source of the fruits of wisdom and perpetual joy.